Hello everyone, welcome to Semstar online classes. I am Rubab Rizvi and I am here to take your computer class.
Today I am going to take your computer class and from now onwards we are going to start assessment 2. You know that, and for assessment 2 I think 3 chapters are coming. Okay, in assessment 2 you have studied so many things about computer. Yes, can you tell me? You studied about computer, a machine, that it is a machine. Then you studied about the different features of computer. There was a very interesting comparison given in your computer book. And so you know that computer has so many features and how computer is so different from human, right? Then you have also studied about the different fields where computers are used. You have also studied about the different types of computers. Isn't it? And then you know about the parts of computer. How many parts are there? There are 4 main parts of a computer. Yes. And then in the 3rd chapter you studied about how computer works. How does computer work? Yes, you remember, computer works through IPO cycle. It works through IPO cycle. I gave you so many examples also related to IPO cycle. Real life examples also of IPO. So you learn so many things, children. Yes, and today we are going to study operating a computer. That is chapter 4. Operating a computer. Chapter 4. Let's see how computers are operated. It means how they work. Operate means how they work. How do we... Yes, let's open to page number 30 and chapter 4. In this chapter, you are going to learn steps to start a computer. Okay, how you start a computer or operate a computer. Yes, how you start a computer, starting a program, resizing and moving a window, and how to shut down a computer. So many things you are going to learn in this chapter. So children, let's read the chapter. Children, in the previous chapter, we have learnt about the parts and functions of a computer. Yes, you know all the parts and functions of a computer. Yes. Now let us learn how to work on a computer. How to work on a computer. To start a computer, follow these steps. Now you have, if I ask you to start a computer, can you open a computer? You have to do all these following steps to start a computer. Let's see what are these steps. The first thing which you are going to do to start a computer is what are you going to do? First thing is that you are going to switch on the power button, right? Switch on the main power supply button, right? See, in the first step, main power supply button. You are going to switch it that, okay? And then the second step is switch on the UPS button. First step is power button. First you have to switch on the power button. Then second, UPS button. What is UPS? Children, UPS is also part of computer. You have not studied about UPS in any of the chapter, but I'll tell you what is UPS. UPS is a device, and when you what is the function of UPS is, children, that suppose you are working on a computer and suddenly the electricity goes off. Suddenly the electricity goes off, the power goes off, light chali jati hai. So what is the work of the UPS? It gives the electricity to the computer. If there is no UPS, the computer will shut down suddenly. At that moment, when the electricity is gone, it will turn down. It will turn off. But if you have a UPS connected to the computer, it supplies electricity. It gives electricity for some more time to the computer, and in the meanwhile, so that you can complete your important work. Means, suppose you are working on a computer on some important work you are doing, some important file you are making, and suddenly the electricity goes off. So what will happen? You will lose all the work, all the work that you were doing, that will be gone because electricity is gone. So what UPS does is, it gives electricity to the computer. Switch on the UPS button. If the electricity goes off, the UPS makes the computer work. It makes computer work for some more time so that you can finish your work and save your files or any other work which you are doing, and then you can turn on the computer. And then the third one is, so for the second step is that first you switch on the power button, then you will switch on the UPS button. Okay, and then you must have seen UPS in the computer lab. Yes, then the third one is to switch on the power supply button of CPU. Then the third step is to switch on the power button of CPU. You must have seen that there is a power button of CPU, right? And you push this button, you switch it on, then the computer work, then the computer start. Yes. Then the fourth step is to switch on the monitor. Like this is a monitor. Yes, children. And there are few buttons on the monitor. You have to switch on this button to start the computer. Switch on the monitor. Okay. The first step is to switch on the main power supply button. Then the second one is to switch on the UPS button, and if the electricity goes off, UPS makes the computer work. Then the third one is switch on the power supply button of the CPU, right? And then the last one is monitor button. You are going to switch on the monitor button to make monitor work. So you will find a welcome screen of the window. When you switch on the monitor, you will find a welcome screen on the monitor. Children, you will enjoy using Windows as it is very easy to use. Now when you switch on the monitor, the windows start loading. Yes, you must have seen the windows start loading and then the computer starts. So that is window. We call it window. And it is very easy to use. Windows is the most popular program that makes the computer work. What is window? Window is a most popular program that makes computer work. Without Windows, you cannot work on computer. Means it will not work. Nothing will be shown on the computer. The first display screen that appears on a starting computer is known as desktop. That means the first thing that you're going to see after switching it on the monitor, that is called desktop. Okay, the first thing that appears on the screen, that is desktop. The desktop holds many small pictures known as icons. Now, when you open it, there are small icons, children. You must have seen. If you notice, you must have seen. There are so many icons made on the desktop. And with the help of mouse, you can select any item, right? You can select any icon of your choice and then start working. This is what you do, children. Yes. So all these small things. What are these called? These are called icon. I-C-O-N-S. All these are icons on the desktop. The first thing that appears on the monitor, that is called desktop. and on the desktop you will see small icons. You can select these items icons and you can start working. Then there is a small thin bar at the bottom of the desktop. Suppose this is a desktop, children. I am going to make a bigger one so that it is clear to you all. Okay, little bigger I have made so that it becomes clear. So these are the icons, right? These are the icons, and then there is a thin bar, and then again there are few icons on this thin bar. The thin bar at the bottom of the desktop is, and what is this called? This is called taskbar. Okay, the icons on the screen, I mean on the desktop, the icons on the desktop, or all these are called, what are all these called? These are called icons. And the thin bar at the bottom of the desktop, that is called taskbar. And you can find few icons here also. And this is called taskbar. Okay, so this is taskbar. When you peep through your bedroom window, you can see different views. In the same way, you can open and view many programs in window like Paint, movies, music and games. Now children, suppose you peep from your window from your house, you peep from your window and see, and you can see so many things outside, right? In the same way, children, what they are saying, in the same way you can open and view many programs in windows. In windows you can do so many things. You can paint, you can play games, you can watch movies, you can do calculations, so many things there. So music and so many things, and on that you can do on windows. Okay, so now you know these are called icons, this is called taskbar, and this whole thing is the desktop. And one more thing, here is the start button. This is a, means this is small icon is given, and this is a start button. Okay, at the end of the taskbar, at the extreme corner, you will see the what? Start button. Okay, when you click on this, you will find so many programs. Okay, like Paint, movies, music, games and so on. Okay, so children, this was about operating a computer. Okay, first thing you are going to do is power button, switch on the main supply of power button, then the UPS, so that when the electricity goes off, your computer works, keep working. Then CPU, you are going to switch on the CPU. Okay, then you are going to switch on the monitor. When you open the monitor, when you switch on the monitor, the first thing that appears on the screen, that is called desktop. This is what they are saying. The first display screen that appears on starting a computer is known as desktop. Then desktop holds so many pictures and they are called icons. Okay, all these are called icons. And you can select any icon of your choice. A thin bar at the bottom, what is this called? This is called taskbar. And there is a small start button at the corner. Okay, when you open it, you will find the start button in the corner. Okay, so this was about computer, how you are going to operate a computer. When we meet children, then I'm going to show you how you're going to operate a computer, and I'm going to show you the icons, the taskbar and everything. Okay, so all this for now. We are going to continue the same chapter in the next video. So all this for now. Take care and bye bye.